The Rift Guardian is here.
What's up, everybody? Kinetic here. Welcome back to Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls. This is patch 2.3, this time with the withered? With the withered! What? Forget it, it's already shot. Welcome back to Diablo 3. Oh man, I've had a long day with this wizard, man. I showed you guys a preview of this build just before the PTR hit here in Diablo 3. I was working on Attil Rasha's build, and I knew that I wanted to hold back doing a full-on show-off of the Attil Rasha's build that I put together until after I've gotten a hand on the PTR. And yeah, good thing that I did, because this build, while a lot of things didn't change, there were definitely some significant improvements here and there with the Kunai Cube. This build feels so good. Out of everything that I've tested on the PTR so far, and I've tested a lot up to this point, this is the most powerful and feels the best for me personally. Like, in terms of gameplay, this Attil Rasha Wizard build that I'm been testing all day today here, trying to get the gems leveled, trying to get the right pieces in the right place and stuff like that. This beats the Crusader build that I've tried, my new Amazian Minion Master build that I've been doing on my Witch Doctor, the Demon Hunter with the multi-shot blasting from Unhallowed Essence. This is doing really, really nicely, and I think I might be playing a lot more Wizard if this stays as fun and as powerful as it is. So, let's go over it, right? We'll start with the gear. Again, like I said, this is a Attil Rasha build. So, we'll talk about the set bonuses. Damaging enemies with arcane cold fire or lightning will cause a meteor of the same damage type to fall from the sky. There is an 8-second cooldown for each damage type, which is a really nice, like, trick that they put in there. If you can, and this is one of the things that I've definitely tried to do a lot with this build, if you have a variety of elements that you can cast at any given time, that means you can have an ice meteor, a fire meteor, arcane meteor, lightning meteor, all falling within like a couple seconds of each other. Really, really powerful stuff. Those meteors are badass, especially with these new boots, the Nilfur's Boast. I got an ancient and I still can't seem to get a decent roll on this this damage increase. The boots increase the damage of meteor by 100% when your meteor hits 3 or fewer enemies. Really nice, it can be up to 200, I don't know why I keep rolling like 150-ish or something every time I find these boots, but anyway, amazing boots right here, and they are definitely going in this slot. I'll talk about what is going on in the Kunai Cube here in a second. Let's go back to the bonuses. 4-piece, attacks increase your resistance to that damage type by 100% for 6 seconds. This is another reason why I'm mixing up all these different elements. I've pretty much got everything. I've got arcane, lightning, fire, ice. So whatever the enemy's, the elite's element is, all I gotta do is make sure, and I pretty much am, casting whatever that element is, and then I'll get a really nice resistance to that damage. 6-piece, attacks increase your damage by 150% for 6 seconds. Arcane cold fire and lightning attacks each add 1 stack. Adding a stack refreshes the duration. This is really cool. You don't even have to really think about this because it's so just, yeah. it's yeah. Okay, so, okay. Here's something that I didn't think of until the last minute when I went back through one of my other characters' inventory and I found, and I remember finding, a new legendary gem that I found, Ice Blink. Your cold skills now apply chill effects, and your chill effects now slow enemy movement by an additional 15%. The 25 rank gained 10% increased critical hit chance against chilled and frozen enemies. And I'm pretty much chilling all day, every day with this wizard, man. Like, blizzards are everywhere constantly, so it's a really nice damage increase against everybody that's getting hit by this, like I said, pretty much on a constant basis. So Serpent Sparker, of course, because we are casting Hydras and Double Hydras, which is our fire element. Witching Hour. With the combination that I have, I'm able to get all six pieces via offhand, pants, chest, head, amulet, and hands, right? Now, the shoulder slot here, Pauldrons of the Skeleton King, this is just because right now I can't think of anything better at this point to maybe possibly, I don't know, add some kind of little gimmick or whatever to this build to possibly escape damage, but it never really seems to work, so I don't know why you bother. Let's go back to the legendary gems, because there's some cool things going on here. So we've got the slow effect of, obviously from the blizzard and from the ice blink. Now this is working really well together with Bane of the Trapped. I've also got this leveled, increased damage against enemies that are under controlling pairing effects, and at the 25 rank I've got the aura, so no matter what, even if there's like some dudes that are trying to like punch me in the face, they're going to be taking buttloads more of extra damage because of that. Also, took me a long time to get on board with this gem, but the gem of Efficacious Toxin. Poison all enemies for X percentage weapon damage over 10 seconds. Here's the kicker. The rank 25, all enemies you poison take 10% damage from all sources. That's a really nice little addition to this. I'm not sure how powerful the poison effect is, but it's just nice that all enemies that are being hit and there's AoE damage all over the place are taking that 10% increased damage. For the gems, the normal gems, I mean, I'm running two amethyst and topaz, thank you. I'm running three topaz just because for my character and sort of like where her health is overall across her gear with intelligence and vitality, this is just where I want it to be. I don't really want her to go any lower than 700k. This seems to me to be the sweet spot right here for balance in general. And I've been toying around with this back and forth, whether I wanted an amethyst for the extra life or whether I wanted the diamond, but I'm definitely, now that I've played with it more, I'm definitely settled on getting that reduced cooldown, because one of the big things, right, that we are trying to accomplish also with this build is we're using Black Hole as a knockback skill with the strong arm bracers. So we want to be able to cast, and it's just a fantastic control ability as well, we want to be able to cast Black Hole as much as humanly possible, because it's a ton of damage when all is put together here, so the more reduced cooldown, the better, really. But I wouldn't put it over, for example, Hydra damage or Meteor damage. Those are the two skill-based attributes that you're trying to re-roll on your gear for. Let's see, I think I'm done talking about the gear. Let's talk about the Paragon points really quick. For the core, maximum arcane power, I'm not sure whether I really need this or not, but it feels good at this point, and to me, the extra, the points that I'm taking away from intelligence, because that's where they would be otherwise, doesn't feel like it's all that that much of a loss in terms of damage. The reason why I've got only 15%, 0.5, I don't know how that happened. It's supposed to be 15% is because these stupid boots rolled with, what was it? It was like, it rolled with some skill damage, which I definitely didn't want, and movement speed. And I'm like, well, either I can get something semi-useful or something completely useless. So I re-rolled the skill and I'm stuck with the, this is just a PTR, thankfully. I'm stuck with the movement speed there. Otherwise, that would probably be vitality or something like that. Let's see, let's go back to the Paragon points. Okay, so yeah. Otherwise, I would have full movement, I think full maximum arcane, and the rest goes into intelligence. The crit hit chance and crit hit damage, followed by cooldown reduction. But Kinetic, didn't you just say you want lots of cooldown reduction? Yes, you do. And if you can go ahead and max these out, like all three at the same time, then fantastic. But this is just kind of where I'm at with my scrubby Paragon points. Whatever works best for your build, but yes, the more cooldown reduction, the better. Attack speed, not so much here. The things that we're casting don't really rely on attack speed all that much. Defense, we're going with armor, life, resist all, even though I've got it not in that order right now, whatever. Utility, definitely resource cost reduction, the area damage, and then life on hit after that. Okay, now, let me pick up my loot, we're gonna go back to town, and we're gonna talk about the Kanai Cube setting. I suppose what I could also do, instead of the Skeleton King pauldrons in the shoulder slot, I could go ahead and put the Zakara spaulders here, make my items indestructible. This could be a nice money saver, because with what's going on in the PTR right now, the repair costs have skyrocketed! Like, fucking seriously! Like, huge repair bills now. Before it was like, okay, it was like, what, 80k or something like that in repair bills? Try 7 million now! It's crazy how much bigger the repair costs are. Now, of course, the reason why that is it's a gold sink. And I think the reason why they've done that is because there's a lot more gold to be had in this game overall, through like bounties, and just there's just a lot more gold going on in the game. Despite the crazy repair costs, I'm now well over a billion gold here. But, you know, it could be nice to, either way, to have something like Zakara or the Skeleton King's Pauldrons, whatever. Whatever floats your boot. Alright, so I'm done cleaning up in the Rift. The items that I'm going for right now in the Kanai Cube are pretty interesting, actually. I mean, it's more or less what I was expecting to put in these slots, except for the weapon slot. The Yunjang Do, however that's pronounced, the attacking enemies below 20% life freezes them for 3 seconds. This is just kind of something I put in because I didn't really have anything else to put in at the time and really didn't think of what else might be good for this build. It's actually really nice though. Attacking enemies below 20% life and freezing them for 3 seconds, combined with all the other control effects, like, it's a really nice way of just shutting down enemies from being able to do anything once they've gotten past that point in low life. So I might go with this actually as the final version for this build. This is just a preview, remember, for what's going on the PTR, but the reason I am, of course, making this video is because I think that it's close to, if not the final version of what I'm thinking about doing with this Tal Rasha build, PTR or not. Tasker and Theo, originally this was slotted in the hands, but with everything, the way that I was shuffling it, I decided that this would be best as a Kanai power, and like I said, it would allow me to go ahead and put the hand slot here. I took the belt out and put in the witching hour. Just overall, this the balance of everything is really nice. Of course, Unity for the survivability. Nothing really seemed like it's as cool as Convention of Elements is. I just can't seem to, I don't know. I really don't know, like, what it is. I guess I hate staring at this stupid thing. Anyway, it's time to go over the skills now, right? So, for our Arcane, I'm going with Magic Missile. This is, of course, also being used for Focus and Restraint. I'm sure you noticed that in the rings. Charged Blast, launch a missile, dealing 325 weapon damage as Arcane. So, this is kind of, I think, the more enhanced version. Blizzard, Frozen Solid. Enemies caught in Blizzard have 100% chance to be frozen for 2.5 seconds. I use this a lot, and it saves me from taking a hit to the face from all kinds of enemies, including Rift bosses. You'll see all kinds of dudes whining up for some big hit, and I'm just like, nope! I just shut them down with that freeze, man. It's so amazing. I love it. Black Hole, Supermassive. You could probably mess with different runes here, but the reason why I go with Supermassive, for one, it's lightning. I'm trying to get lightning in here with all the elements and stuff like that. I love the size of it. It's really, really nice. It pulls in a lot of enemies with how big it is. It's really great. Energy armor, force armor for the survivability here. When you take damage, it's not gonna mean massive amounts of damage, only a certain amount. The magic weapon, force weapon, granting 20% increased damage for the time that this buff is up, and like I said, Hydra, Mammoth Hydra for fire. These guys spew fire all over the place. It's lovely. I love it. Elemental exposure, glass cannon, cold-blooded, and unstable anomaly. Unstable anomaly. Now, I don't think I have to explain elemental or anomaly, but I like Glass Cannon because it doesn't seem to really cost me that much in terms of survivability, and overall, again, maybe that's why I'm now going with the Unity, because I like the survivability from that, rather than Convention of Elements, increasing my damage by 15%. Fantastic. Cold-Blooded. I was messing around back and forth between Cold-Blooded and Conflagration. I decided on Cold-Blooded because it's just, well, I think it's more consistent. Enemies chilled or frozen by you take 10% more damage from all sources. Enemies chilled or frozen. Going back to our legendary gem, apply chill effects and stuff like that. So we've just got so much here that is not very finicky, I guess, as far as like the damage multiplication. Some builds that I play, like, they can be fragile in the way that these damage multiplications happen. Like, it really relies on one skill, and maybe that skill has a cooldown or something like that. Just there's a very consistent amount of multiplication going on here from the legendary gems and the passives. Really, really fun. Amazing build. I'm loving it, man. This, like I said, is kicking the ass of everything else that I've tested here on the PTR. I'm gonna stop rambling. See, this is why. I'm gonna stop rambling before I get any more tongue-tied. Here's some gameplay footage from that rift that I just cleared. Enjoy.
I've been healed. the look of that.
Heels.
The Rift Guardian has come.
I'm badly wounded. No, you have triumphed. I can't carry anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this video on my Tal Rasha Withered here in Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls. This is, like I said, the PTR, so anything here is subject to change as far as like different values on items and stuff like that. They may, I don't know, who knows, they may change some of the percentages and stuff like that on different skills or item pieces and stuff like that, but for the most part, I think that this build is going to stay the way that it is. I don't think they're gonna mess with it. It doesn't seem like it needs to be messed with at all. I'll tell you what does need to be messed with. They need to buff those new Witch Doctor sets. Oh my god, that was embarrassing. Like when I was live streaming those sets, how bad they were, man. Oh, but thankfully not so bad here on the PTR for the Wizard. There is the before I go, there is the Vires set that I'm going to be experimenting with. I haven't actually tried it out, but Archon is looking like it's back from what people are saying, and it seems like it could be a really fun build to play, certainly. The Delseer set also seems to be getting a lot of praise right now from all, and I can see it too, like there's a lot of really cool pieces that you can mix in the Kanai Cube, I think, for this set as well. I'll be trying that out. I'll be trying out the Archon as well over probably the next week. I'm gonna keep playing around with the Wizard. Now that I've kind of finalized the way that I think this Tal Rasha build is gonna work, I'm gonna mess around with the other sets, and I'm looking forward to that. And I'm looking forward to them fixing the Witch Doctor sets as well, because they sound fun, but man, are they bad right now. As soon as they fix those, you can expect to see probably some previews of that here on the PTR as well for Witch Doctor. That's all for now, guys. I want to know what you guys think down in the comment section below. Click the like button to support these Diablo 3 videos here on the channel, and make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss the next video. Thanks again for watching. My name is Kinetic, and I'll see you next time.